You can translate it. So today is the appearance day of Srila Jiva Goswami Pada. His direct disciple of Srila Rupa Goswami Pada. And Srila Rupa Goswami Pada engaged him in the service of Sanshodhan. It means proofreading all his writings, all his books. Gurudev did not feel satisfied with the word Sanshodhan proofreading, because Srila Rupa Goswami Pada cannot make any mistake. But anyway, he engaged Srila Jiva Goswami Pada in this way to bestow mercy upon him. So appearing this world as nephew of Rupa Goswami and Sanatana Goswami, and he preached all the teachings of Rupa Goswami, but he supported them with evidence and explained them from the point of view of the darshan, the philosophical point of view. He has written Gopal Champu and explained all the pastimes of Krishna from point of view of philosophy. It seems that Srila Jiva Goswami Pada has supported Swakya Vada, the conception that Radha and Krishna are married, and that Vishnu Chaitakar has supported Parikya Vada. But Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur, he has reconciled the explanations of both of them and called this Vichara Vaishishtya, or only a speciality in their viewpoints, but not actually a difference in philosophy. So Srila Vishnathaka Thakur, he's not less than Srila Jiva Goswami. He's composed so many granthas. He's commented on the Bhaktivinoda Samhita Sindhu and the Lagu Bhagavatamrita and the Ujjwala Nilamani of Srila Rupa Goswami in his three books, Bindu, Kiran and Kana. He's written Madhurya Kadambini, which is also commentary on Adoshada, etc. from Bhaktivinoda Samhita Sindhu. And he has also explained three verses dealing with Raghunuga Bhakti from Bhaktivinoda Samhita Sindhu in his book Radha Bhatma Chandrika. Srila Vishnachami Thakur has written commentaries on Bhaktivinoda Samhita Sindhu and Ujjwala Nilamani, Ananda Chandrika Tika. And he has written commentary on the 10th canto of Srimad Bhagavatam, Sarada Darshini. So Vishnachami Thakur wrote very prolifically. And Srila Jiva Goswami Pada himself, he wrote many commentaries on Srimad Bhagavatam, including six sandarbhas, and he also wrote commentary on Ujjwala Nilamani, Bhaktivinoda Samhita Sindhu. So today, on his appearance day, we pray to him and remember his lotus feet, because especially he is eternal associate of Mahaprabhu and he is the eternal associate of Sri Radha Krishna in his form as Sri Vilas Mandir. So now Srila Gurudev will continue with the explanation of Srila Sanat Goswami Pada's great Bhagavatamrita Bhakti Rasa.
Jayati Jana Nivato Devaki Janma Vato Devaki Janma Vato. आज जन निवासों में हमने कुछ सनातन गोस्वामी के विचार प्रकट किए। जन माने निखिल विश्व ब्रह्मांड के जीवों के आश्रय, और आश्रय होते हुए भी सबके हृदय में निवास, जन निवास, जनों के हृदय में निवास करने वाले हैं, सबके आश्रय हैं, सब उनमें हैं, और वो भी उनमें हैं, जन निवास। अथवा जन निवास माने स्वजन वाचक जन, कृष्ण के निजी जन है स्वजन वाचक, अपने भक्त का उनके हृदय में विशेष रूप से निवास करते हैं, और सबके हृदय में साक्षी के रूप में निवास करते हैं। किस रूप में? परमात्मा रूप, और अपने निजजन, अपने भक्तों के हृदय में राज्य रूप कृष्ण के रूप में हुए, और गोपियों के साक्षी के रूप में उनके हृदय में किस रूप में रहेंगे? गोपी जन बल्लभ के रूप में रहेंगे। इसलिए अपने भक्तों के हृदय में सब समय स्फूर्ति प्राप्त होते रहते, मुझे प्राप्त होते रहते हैं। मैंने जब कृष्ण का चिंतन करती हैं वो या निज भक्तगण गोपियां, तो उनके इंद्रियों पर प्रत्येक इंद्रियों में वो स्फुट होते हैं, समस्त इंद्रियों में ही, आंखों में शब्द के रूप में, नाटक सुगंध के रूप में, समस्त रूप में जैसे चैतन्य महाप्रभु के जीवन में देखा जाता है। और ये तो अंतर में स्फूर्ति प्राप्त है, और बाहर में नाना प्रकार के अवतारों में प्रकट होकर के अवस्थान करते हैं। नाना प्रकार के अवतार स्वयं वही हैं, और इसको ये भी कहा जा सकता है कि इन रूप में प्रकट होते हैं या अपने से इन लोगों को प्रकट करते हैं। जब सपनों का ये थे आया समझने के लिए, कृष्ण ही राम निशिंग बगल की पावन है और अलग से नहीं है, कोई तत्व नहीं, या अपने से अपनी स्वरूप शक्ति से अपने रहते हुए भी और अपने से सब अवतारों को प्रकट करते। एक तो पहला हुआ जो स्वयं कृष्ण ही अवतार, राम निशिंग कल की बामन और नहीं है, कृष्ण ही है। और दूसरा अपने से प्रकाश करते हैं, इसके द्वारा पर ब्रह्म परमात्मा सर्वेश्वर और सर्व अवतारी का बीज कृष्ण को कहा गया। इसलिए कृष्ण को पर ब्रह्म, ब्रह्म तो सभी है किंतु परब्रह्म में नहीं, ये ब्रह्म परमात्मा, परमात्मा माने परमात्मा, आत्माओं में भी परमात्मा, परम परमात्मा ये भी कर सकते हैं। सर्वेश्वरेश्वर समस्त ईश्वरों के भी ईश्वर है, अनादिराज गोविंद, और सब अवतारों के बीज हैं, इन्हीं से सभी प्रकटित होते हैं, और उन्हीं स्वरूपों में ऐश्वर्य इत्यादि की परम काष्ठा, उन रूपों में ऐश्वर्य की परम काष्ठा है। साक्षात प्रकट द्वारा वो देवकी जन्म भाव स्वयं प्रकट होते हैं, साक्षात प्रकट के द्वारा भी तब देवकी के गर्भ से प्रकट होते हैं, जन्म बाद ये प्रसिद्धि है। अथवा दूसरा अर्थ करेंगे पाद मात्र, विवाद मात्र है, अर्थात यशोदा के पुत्र हैं, उसमें बाद नहीं है, इसमें जन्म बाद है। और जन्म बाद में एक और भी होता है प्रसिद्धि, देवकी से जन्म ग्रहण कर जाते हैं, इसलिए वे देवकी पुत्र, वसुदेव पुत्र, देवकी नंदन इत्यादि नामों से परिख्यात है। विशेष करके जन्म के कारण गोकुल आनंद इत्यादि संबंधी गोकुल में देवकी वसुदेव को कहा कि हमको गोकुल में ले चलो, और वो ले गए। इसके पहले इसमें ये भी आ जाएगा कृष्ण जगत में क्यों प्रकट हुए। पहला कारण असुरों का विनाश करके धर्म की प्रतिष्ठा करना, परित्रणाय साधु नाम विनाशाय च दुष्कृताम् धर्म संस्थापनाय समवामी चुके। इसके अतिरिक्त ऋषियों मुनियों के किसी को वर दिया गया है, किसी को अभिशंपात दिया गया है उसको पूर्ण करने के लिए। नारद जी ने अभिशंपात किया और जाओ तुम कृषि द्वापर युग में वृक्ष होकर के जन्म लेगा और वहीं पर तुम्हारा उद्धार होगा। दंडकारण्य वासियों को पर दिया था उनको भी पूरा करने के लिए। तो मैं इन सबको गौण मानता हूँ। मुख्य क्या मानता हूँ? अपने भक्तों का, गोपियों का विनोदन करने के लिए मथुर रस से उनके साथ में क्रीड़ा कौतुकी, क्रीड़ा कौतुक कहते हैं, या क्रीड़ानक, क्रीड़नक माने कुत्सल, उनके हाथ के कुत्सल बनते हैं। इसके लिए ये जगत में दिखाने के लिए ये प्रेम के कितने वशी होते हैं, प्रेम को प्रकट करने के लिए और उनकी अधीनता पराधीनता स्वीकार करने के लिए आना ही मुख्यतः उनका प्रयोजन है। अंत में गो माता भूभाष्य त्रस्त होकर के दस ब्रह्मा के शरण में गई गाय का रूप धारण किया, क्योंकि गाय कृष्ण को बहुत प्यारी है और वो शंकर इत्यादि को लेकर के फिर सावर के निकट पहुंचे और पहुंच करके आराधना की और उनकी समाधि में ये सुनने में आया कि मैं प्रकट हो रहा हूं, हम हमारी सेवा के लिए गोकुल में ये सब जितने देवता लोग हैं और लोग अपने आए और राधा जी की सेवा करने के लिए गोकुल में और मथुरा में वो जन्म हो। इस प्रकार से ये सब लीलाओं को उसके अंदर में समझो। विशेष करके जन्म होने के बाद में वसुदेव महाराज कृष्ण को किसी भी पात्र में कहते हैं सूप में, उनको लेकर यमुना जी को पार किया, श्रीगाल ने पथ दिखलाया, योग माया ने व्यवस्था की और शेष नाग ने छत्र धारण किए वर्षा से, वर्षा कृष्ण के जन्म में हो रही थी, बड़ी आंधी चल रही थी, क्यों? योग माया की क्रिया। ये सब लोग सो रहे हैं, कोई बाहर नहीं निकलेगा रात में, और आधी रात में सभी लोग सो जाएंगे, इसलिए उत्तम काल चुन करके उत्तम उपायों के द्वारा योग माया में सारी व्यवस्था की और गोप दे आए तथा मेरी बेटी अपने आप खुल गई, दरवाजे पट खुल गए, लोगों के सात दरवाजे और वहां गए, देखा सो रही है जसोदा मैया, नंद बाबा सो रहे हैं और उनका भी कपाट खुल गया, वहां रख करके और लड़की को ले आया, दोनों एक हो गए। इत्यादि ये सब लीलाओं को जो श्रीमद् भागवत में या अन्यत्र वर्णन किए गए हैं किसी के अंतर्गत में चिंतन लीला चिंतन कर नहीं कहेंगे, इसलिए ये श्लोक संपूर्ण भागवत का सार। ऐसे जो अपूर्व सिद्धांत हैं, वृतांत हैं, मातृ पितृ प्रतिस्तुति, देवताओं ने माता पिता की स्तुति की, इन लोग माता पिता ने भी कृष्ण के जन्म होने के बाद में जब चतुर्भुज रूप में देखा कहा जोड़ करके और गर्भ में देवताओं ने स्तुति की, उसमें सत्य प्रथम परम सत्य सत्यात्मकम काम शरण और वे गोकुल में आए। अच्छा जो सीरियल निकले हैं ना सब उल्टा पुल्टा, उसमें देखा है नंद बाबा जगे हुए हैं और क्या क्या किए हैं,
now Srila Gurudev is explaining the commentary of Srila Sanatana Goswami Pad on this very important verse of Srimad Bhagavatam, Jai Jitana Nivasu Devaki Dhammaradam. So first, Jayati Jana Nivaso. All glories to Jana Nivas. Nivas means residence place. And Jana means people. So this can have many meanings. First of all, that Krishna is ashray, is the shelter or residence place of all people, all jivas, all living entities. Everyone exists within him. And another meaning, Jananivas, means that all people are the residence place of Krishna. In other words, he lives inside them. He's in the heart of everyone. So everyone exists in him, and he also exists within everyone. So he's called Jananivas. Another meaning, the word Jan can be taken to mean Swajan or Nijajan. That means he resides in the association of his own near and dear associates and family members. And also, he resides within their hearts in a special way, in the very form in which they always remember him as their beloved. So, for the general people, he resides in their hearts. How? As Paramatma. And for the devotees, he resides in their heart as their Ishtadev. And for his Nijajan in Vrindavan, such as the gopis, he's always in the heart of gopis, in his form as Gopijana Balabha. So what does it mean that he resides in their heart? It means that they attain a spurti of him. They attain a vision of him within their heart. But what kind of spurti? This is not only a vision. This is a spurti of all their senses. In other words, moment by moment, they realize how he looks. They realize his fragrance. How his, the sound of his voice and his flute. By all senses, they have spurti of him within their heart, and therefore, Jayati Jananivasa. So every word has so many meanings which are suitable for meditation of the devotee. So here, Jananivasa is the shelter of everyone, also means that all avatars have come from him. He's Sarveshvareshvara. He's the supreme controller of all controllers. He's the avatar beach. He's the root cause of all incarnations. Anadiradi Govinda, Savakana Karana. Krishna has become Ram. Krishna has become Narasimhadev. Krishna has become Vamandev. All the incarnations, they're all Krishna's own forms. He's Parabrahma. Jananivas also indicates that he's Parabrahma. He's the supreme absolute truth. He's Paramatma, and he's the Paramakasta, the ultimate limit of Aishwarya, all opulence. So, now, Srila Gurudev has explained Jananivas, now he's explaining Devaki Janmavado. So, compare these two. Jananivas is the ultimate limit of all opulence. All avatars have come from him. So he's Swayam Prakash. Jananivas indicates that he's self-manifest. But that person who is self-manifest, he is what? Devaki Janma. He chooses by his own sweet will to be born from the womb of Devaki. So here, Janmavad, Devaki Janmavad has so many meanings. One meaning of Janmavad means that his birth from the womb of Devaki is Vad. Here the word Vad means it's well known. Everyone speaks about it. It's prasiddha. It's famous. So he is famous as the son of Devaki. But another meaning of the word Vad, Vad means vivad, argument, controversy. In other words, it is a point of controversy whether he's the son of Devaki or not. So, he's famous as Vasudev Putra, son of Vasudev. He's famous as Devaki Nanda. This is true. But he told Vasudev Maharaj, after his appearance, take me to Gokul. And Vasudev Maharaj carried him to Gokul. Why did Krishna appear? What is the reason for this Devaki Janmavad? Why did he appear? There are so many reasons. First of all, Krishna said in Gita, Parikla Naya Sadhunam, Vinasha Sajuskitam, Dharma Sanstapanataya Sampavana Yuge Yuge. Millennium after millennium, I appear to establish religious principles. I appear to protect and deliver those who are sadhus, my devotees. And I appear to destroy all the demons. So all these pastimes of reciprocating with the devotees and destroying demons, all are included here in this katha, Jati Jana Nivaso Devaki Jambavado. Oh, why did Krishna appear? Because Narad had given a curse to the sons of Kuvera, Nala Kuvera and Manigri. And when they begged for mercy, okay, you become trees. But in Dwapara Yuga, when Krishna appears, then he'll deliver you. So Krishna appeared to fulfill the promise of Narad to Nala Kuvera and Manigriva. Why did Krishna appear? Because in his incarnation as Lord Ram, when he met the rishis of Dandakaranya, they had a desire to become his beloveds. But it was not possible in that incarnation. So he gave a benediction to them, and therefore to fulfill the benediction which was offered to the rishis, he has appeared. Jati Jana Nivaso, Devaki Jana Tavaro. So all these katas, they come in this life. They will be meditated upon the devotee on the basis of this life. But Srila Gurudev said that the mukhya prayojan, the main objective of his appearance, was to manifest to the whole world the glories of the praying of the gopis, and to show to the world how he is a dinata, that means he's subjugated, he's controlled and submissive to the gopis because of their influence, of their supreme love for him. So, how did he appear? Why did he appear? Prithivi, the goddess of earth, assumed the form of a cow because cows are very dear to Krishna. And along with Brahmaji and Shiva, they came to the shore of the ocean of milk and they offered prayers. And then, through Kiradakshaya Vishnu, Krishna sent the message that soon I will appear, so the demigods should also take birth in Yadav dynasty and Vrishni dynasty in order to render service and assist in these pastimes. So, after Krishna appeared in Mathura, then Vasudev Maharaj carried him to the Jamuna. There was very heavy rainfall, but Anantashesh appeared above him and protected him from the rain. He could not see a way to cross the Jamuna because it was flooded and very flooded and very turbulent. But Yolamaya sent one jackal who was crossing at a particular place that was shallow to show him the way. At that time, no one saw anything. Everyone was asleep. Even when he arrived in Gokul, Nandaba was asleep, Mother Yashoda was asleep, and he put down Krishna, and Vasudev Krishna merged with Yashoda Nandan Krishna. And he picked up the baby girl and returned. And no one saw a thing. Why? Because Yogamaya made everyone sleep. So Yogamaya, she makes all perfect arrangements for the pastimes of Krishna. And therefore, this verse is the essence of Srimad Bhagavatam. And Srila Siddhartha Goswami Pad, through the medium of his commentary, is explaining to all the devotees in what way they should do Leela Smaran, in what way they should chant Harinam and remember this verse and meditate on all the pastimes of Krishna from the very beginning. When Krishna was in the womb of Devaki, at that time, all the demigods headed by Brahma and Shiva, they came and they did Stavstuti, they offered prayers to Devaki, when Krishna was in her womb. And then, when Krishna manifested in his four-handed form, Vasudeva and Devaki, they also offered Stavan Stuti to Krishna, very famous verses glorifying him as the absolute truth. So in this way, the devotees, they remember this verse, and this verse causes manifestation in their heart of all of the pastimes of Krishna from beginning to end.
Army. इतने करना कृपालु दयालु हैं, स्वयं वसुदेव और देवकी को अपना पूर्व जन्म वृतांत सुनाया। पहले जन्म में तुम देवी, तुम कश्यप और आदि की थी। लाख वर्ष तुम लोगों ने तपस्या, कठोर तपस्या की। क्या
बहुत तपस्या की
तो मैंने दर्शन दिया आगे पर मांगो बस तो कश्यप जी ने अथवा कृष्णी का कृष्णी उन लोगों ने पर मांगने के लिए जब कहा तो उन्होंने कहा कि वो हमारी पत्नी अदिति बतलाएगी या सुतपा बतलाएगी तो उन लोगों ने कहा तुम्हारा जैसा पुत्र हमको हो तो कृष्ण ने कहा कि मैंने सोचा कि हमारे जैसा तो और पृथ्वी में और कोई कई त्रिलोकी में नहीं है इसलिए मैं ही तुम्हारे पुत्र के रूप में आया हूँ और जिस रूप से हमारी आराधना थी शंख चक्र गदा पद्म जपों में से ही लेकर के आया तो उनको विश्वास हुआ फिर हाथ जोड़ करके सौ सुखी और उधर कृष्ण ने स्वयं यशोदा मैया नंद बाबा को नहीं कहा वो तो ब्रह्मा जी के हो करके इसको बल्कि पाया बनाई सुखदेव गोस्वामी ने और व्यास देव जी ने पढ़ने कृष्ण को अपनी कहानी कहानी की जरूरत यह ऐसी मई लीला नहीं होनी इसलिए उनसे अपने आप नहीं कहा बल्कि इन लोगों ने वर्णन किया कि पहले जन्म में हम द्रोण और पशु थे ये लोग द्रोण और धारा थे और उसके पहले भी द्रोण धारा थे वो लोग बहुत तपस्या की किसकी ब्रह्मा जी की तपस्या की और उससे वो प्रसन्न होकर के आए और बोले थे पर मांगो उन्होंने कहा कि तुम्हारा कृष्ण के प्रति परब्रह्म कृष्ण के प्रति हमारी वात्सल्य भक्ति हो वात्सल्य प्रेम भक्ति हो वात्सल्य ये पुत्र हमें काबर नहीं मांगा आज इन लोगों ने एक ही वाक्य से दोनों चीज मांगे कृष्ण के प्रेम से मांग लिया कि बेटा भी और वात्सल्य रस भी सभी कुछ इन्होंने मांग लिया बुद्धिमान थे कहते ये ब्रह्मा जी के बस से कैसे हो गया तो इसलिए हो गया कि ब्रह्मा जी जानते थे भविष्य को और इसलिए उनको जान करके देखा जैसे ये तो आएंगे उस वंश में पर्यन्य के मंत्र में आएंगे इसलिए उन्होंने कह दिया ये ठीक है तुम्हारे पुत्र होकर के आएंगे क्योंकि वो जानते हैं इसलिए उन्होंने कह दिया इसमें अस्पति जीविका भी नहीं आई अस्पत जो मिश्रित है कि जो माधुरी की पाराता इस प्रकार से इन सबको इसके अंदर में ले लेना चाहिए ये सब लीलाओं को और फिर वहां आकर सूतना वाली लीला नंद बाबा का मथुरा में जाना संस्था कर चुकाना और आने को पुतना का शरीर देखा और उसे जलाया तो अगुरु हो गया ये भी देखा और तब से यशोदा मैया का प्रेम और दुगुना चौगुना बीसगुना और भी बढ़ने लगा तो क्या कहते हैं रिन्यू नवीनीकरण प्रेम एक रस में रहने से जिसमें तरंगे नहीं है विलास नहीं है वो प्रेम शिथिल होता इसलिए ब्रजवासियों का अपने प्रति प्रेम तरंगमय बनाने के लिए कभी पुतना को लाते हैं कभी सकता सुर को चिणावर्त को नहीं तो ये असुर ब्रज में आ नहीं सकते इसे असुरों का आना ये क्या है योग माया की क्रिया है कृष्ण की इच्छा को पूर्ण करने के लिए इसलिए इन सब लीलाओं को भी इसके अंतर्भुक्त कर लेना है अब
Now Srila Gurudev explained, furthermore, this line, Jayatidinanivaso Devaki Janmavado, it also communicates to the devotees that Krishna is very, very merciful, very compassionate. Why? That he has been, that he took birth either in connection with Vasudeva Devaki or Nanda and Yashoda. This shows his great mercy. Why? Because Vasudeva Devaki, in a previous birth, their names were Krishni and Sutapa, and they did very, very hard austerities, and they worshipped Lord Narayan. And they, when they satisfied him, he wanted to give them a benediction. So they prayed to him, "We want to have a son like you." So Lord Narayan, he said, "There's no one like me, so myself, I will have to become your son. And I will show you my flying form, because that is the form in which you have done my aradhana." So after that, then he also appeared as their son when in their next birth, Krishna and Sutapa became Kasyapa and Aditi. And then in their next birth, they became Vasudev and Devaki. So, now, Mother Yashoda and Nanda Maharaj. Narada and Vyas, they have explained in the Shastra that in a previous life they were Drona and Dara. They have their eternal forms, but there are sadhus who enter into them. So Drona and Dara, they did very hard austerities to satisfy Lord Brahma. Now we see in the relationship between Krishna and Vasudeva and Devaki, Krishna directly told Vasudeva and Devaki, "Oh, you have worshipped me in your previous lives and you have been my mother and father, this is the third time." He said them directly. But Krishna never said directly to Vasudeva, sorry, to Nanda Maharaj and Madhya Shoda. Why? Because this is Madhurya Lila. In Madhurya Lila, if this will be revealed, the Lila cannot be full of sweetness. So it was not told by Krishna directly himself, but Vasudev, sorry, the spirit of Vyasudev, and now they have explained these things. So, Drona and Dara, they did austerities, and they took a benediction from Lord Brahma. They did not ask Lord Brahma that Bhagavan should become their son, but rather they asked, "Oh, we want to love Bhagavan in Vatsalya Rasa." So this includes that he should be their son. So they were more intelligent, because Vasudeva and Devaki, they wanted the Lord as their son. But the moment he appeared, they lost him, so they had no chance to relish the Vatsalya Rasa. So by asking for Vatsalya Rasa Seva, they got Krishna as their son, and also they were able to relish this service. So Ramaji, he gave his benediction, and he knew what was happening in the future. He has no power to benedict them, actually, but he knew what would happen in the future, so he informed them that you will, he told Drona, "You will appear in the dynasty of Parjanya." So Parjanya is the father of Nanda Maharaj. And Supreme Lord will become your son. So in this verse, Aishwarya is there. It is included. But the verse also includes the ultimate limit of the Madhurya Leelas also. So when Krishna, Devaki Janmavado, he appeared in Gokul, then what happened? Kamsa sent Putana. How is this Krishna manifesting his mercy to his devotees? We see that when Putana came, Nanda Maharaj was not there. He had gone to Mathura. And when he was coming back, then the Vrijavasis, they were burning the body of the deceased Putana. And fragrance was coming like a guru. And he smelled this fragrance. But Madhya Shoda, she was there. And by this pastime, our Putana coming to Vrindavan, she had so much fear that Krishna was in danger. And then somehow or other, by the mercy of Narayan, Krishna was saved. And therefore, this is Krishna's mercy on his devotees. Because by these pastimes, he renews their frame. Their frame is already new. But by coming into danger and causing anxiety, then their frame intensifies even more. So Srila Gurudev said that these pastimes of the demons coming to Vrindavan in Krishna's childhood, what do they do? The Vrijavasis have frame. And their frame is like an ocean. But the ocean is more beautiful when it has waves in it. So Yogamaya arranges for the demons to come to Vrindavan to make the ocean of the Vrijvasis praying Tarangita. That means all very beautifully full of waves.
Krishna Bhakta Kripa Ki Vishishtata Bhagavan Ki Kripa Se Bhi Adhik Dikhlai Gai Brahma Ji Ke Par Se Kama Adhutya Bhav Aaya Nanda Nandan Ke Putra Me Vatsalya Bhav Aaya Aar In Me Vatsalya Bhav Na Karke Putra Bhav Aaya Isliye Bhagavan Ki Kripa Se Bhi अधिक वैशिष्ट आई डोंट वॉट यू हैव प्लेन दी स्पेशलिटी ऑफ भक्त मर्सी इज मोर सुपीरियर देन द मर्सी ऑफ हिमसेल्फ कृष्ण सो यू शुड ट्राई टू प्रेज भक्त. If you want to have Krishna more, his love and affection more, and in these bhakta, gopis are most superior in them Radhika, so why not to take the feet of Radhika and then our whole is as such. Go pranam.
There's one short announcement to make. These are the results from the book distribution marathons in Jayapur and Delhi. The party headed up by Shripada Bhaktivedanta Damodar Maharaj of Jayapur did 650 small books, 650 medium books, and 175 big books for a total of almost 1,500 books. And they collected 30,000 rupees and turned in a good portion of that. And the Delhi party, they haven't broken it down for me, but they did 4,000 books and they turned in, they collected about 30,000 rupees and turned in about 40,000. A total of 5,500 big books in 10 days. Big books in 10 days. And now I'd like to invite everyone for the next marathon called Gurudev is in Jammu. This time I've got a chart. I'll put this up on the wall out here. You can sign up for this 5 or 6 parties going to Delhi and other places. Smaller groups this time, and we'll also meet on the weekends for big Nagar Sankirtan at India Gate and other places. So if you'd like to join the book distribution, well, Gurudev is in Jammu, and I think Shripada Damodar Maharaj is going there to Jammu, so let's see if he can beat us again. And we're looking forward. Then when Gurudev comes back, he's going to be doing a program at Janakpuri, and then again the next weekend in Faridabad. So we will have an opportunity to also invite tens of thousands of people. Last in Delhi, we had about 10,000 invitations to Gurudev's 5-day Noida Rathyatra and Pandal program coming up next weekend. If you're interested in that program also, arranging buses and accommodation, please let me know if you're interested to go to the Noida 5-day party.
गोपेन्दे इहशं शरे बलिया मना नपाय तेरे से